keep it player, why some choose to play it safe? But check the resume, it's risky business in the A. I keep it player, why some choose to play it safe? But check the resume, it's risky business in the A. In the A, in the A, in the A, in the A.
It's just really about all about emotion. The dude Justin did it, and the whole album is like a collage of emotion and expression. So he did it with paint, and I love how he did it. He accentuated my cheekbone and everything came out good.
Okay.
The albums are basically like time capsules that capture the time of your life from the last time that the listener heard you. So it's like, you know, been 2.5-3 years, and this was been going on with me. And yeah, it's just all feelings and emotion. I love it. Yep, definitely in-house. I deal with the Flush music, Royal Flush. Also, my homeboy Chris Carmouche, Arthur McArthur, John Hall. Organized Noise, of course, and you know I co-produce every song on the record, so you know I had to touch everything. Heavy writing role, heavy producing role, and you know it turned out really good. I'm happy with it.
Okay.
Well, everything is basically like organically created, never genetically modified. Like with the ASAP Rocky collab, I was at Greg Street show and he was coming up next and bumped into him in the hallway and told me he was coming to Stank On. He was like, I'm going to Stank On with y'all. And he came up an hour later, he was in the studio. T.I. fell through and DJ Drama the same night. And you know, just that's just how music happens. I like it like that.
Okay.
Vicious Lies and Dangerous Rumors is my grandmother, rest her soul. Like she passed away about a year ago, like around this time, and that was gonna be the name of her book. And she always was like, you know, if I put my book out, I'll fuck the whole family up, cause I'ma tell where all the babies at that y'all niggas ain't, all where all the bodies buried and everything. And she was just hard as hell, man. Edna Mae Cares, that's my grandma. And on the flip side of that, it was like, you know, with it being the age of information, like everything is at the touch of a button, whether it be if you want to find out about fitness, history, politics, whatever, you can push a button because the whole world is connected and get answers. And on the other side of that, you have social media where Twitter and Instagram and everything, where somebody can say something and people will take it as the truth, so you have to find it for yourself. So it's always in search of the truth, definitely. I mean, if it's information, like as far as tweets go, I get it out there. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to just have a timeline full of buy my album, buy my song, my video came out, guess what picture I took, look at me, I look good. You know what I'm saying? It's like, okay, this is what happened in California, this is what happened in Washington, this is what happened in Florida, whatever, whoop de whoop. I try to just kind of give them information, so that's what you do, you know? I mean, sometimes you might get like a Thanksgiving picture or a picture at the birthday table at the dinner or something like that, but for the most part, this is really just about just giving, pushing information out.
Okay.
It's the whole thing first. I mean, my favorite song I have right now is Descending, because it was like the last song that we did with me and Yukimi, and I didn't play it 1,000 times yet. But I mean, you listen to the whole thing, and then I guess in a couple of weeks or a couple of months, I have a favorite or so. But right now, it's just like the whole thing. You gotta listen to it. It's 1 hour and 7 minutes. It's a dope ride of music, and I think the people are gonna love that.
Okay.
I'm having fun, you know what I mean? It's not for monetary means or nothing like that. It's strictly because it's what I love to do. It's what I was put here to do, and I'm having fun. I think when people listen to my records, they can see that, like, this dude is really having a good time. And I am, you know, definitely.
Okay.
Love it, love it. Like, everybody's not gonna be able to make the same type of music, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm a player first and foremost, so I'm always congratulating. Like, what people don't know about these new artists is, like, their music, these guys tour abroad, like Europe and Japan and Switzerland, Australia, things like that. The same places where I go, where it keeps the art form growing. Everybody not gonna make the same type of music.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But if people can dig it, don't hate on the next man.
Okay.
I guess it's gonna be a fun year. You know, my last record, I toured like 18 months off of it. I'm gonna do it like a whole, at least a year, because I have like a lot of scripts for movies and films and TV shows and stuff that I've just been kind of forfeiting to get the music out. But now that the music is done, that I can get out there and really do it now.
Okay. Yeah.
The Temptation, Silent Night, favorite of all time. Can't nobody beat that.
Okay.
From the high notes to the low notes. No, none of you niggas can beat that. Period.
Okay.
Not even Players Ball can beat that.
Okay.
And I was on Players Ball. I love it, man. Like I said, we sent the song out to the Falcons and the Hawks, and my man George brought it to my attention tonight. We need to send it to the UGA people too, because they got a big game going on this weekend. So it's all Dirty South, man. It's red clay. Mm-hmm. And I mean, we the home team, man. We ride for it, for sure. Three keys to success, I would say, first and foremost, it means stay hungry, stay humble. And to me, I always say a student. Like, I mean, you haven't mastered everything. You don't know everything. Like, to me and Stax is always consider ourselves students of the game, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So you're always trying to learn new things and always trying to just really learn something new about music.
Mm-hmm.
And something that's going to keep you inspired. And that's what it's all about. You know, that's how you stay hungry. When you stay a student, you want to learn more and more about it. You don't nobody know everything, you know?
True.
And I'm diamond. 10 times flat, diamond. Samuel L. Jackson, because I like to curse, and he cursed good. Like, he could curse really good. I learned how to curse my grandma. I love to cuss. For real. I got a potty mouth. I cuss like a sailor. Yeah.
All
curse
right.
Words. I love it.
All life too short.
Let them flow. Bitch, goddamn asshole. That's it. Definitely when the album comes out, then I'm gonna have Left Foot by Crooks and Castles. My homeboy Rob, been knowing him for like maybe 15 years, man. It's my partner. We're gonna get you fresh on the calf muscles. It's just really super dope, man. Just look out for it. Left Foot by Crooks. The designs are coming out probably the next couple of weeks.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So you gotta do blank when you in the A.
You gotta do Magic City when you in the A, definitely.
Mama told me blank, but I didn't listen.
Mama told me don't get done from everybody, but I didn't listen.
Go by Vicious Lies and Dangerous Rumors if.
Go by Vicious Lies and Dangerous Rumors if you want to hear the most dopest music on the planet, definitely.
She Hates Me Because.
She Hates Me Because. Damn, that's a good one. She Hates Me Because she can't stay hate me for long, because she love getting me top. How about that?
Blank are the best shoes for running.
Air Max 95s are the best shoes for running.
Okay. Blank caused the most tremendous damage in 2012.
The government caused the most damage in 2012.
Okay. I like to eat raspberries with
whipped cream.
And people who gossip.
My mom over there. Couple years, mom. People who gossip suck on the devil's dick. All right, good.
Thank you.